Recording in progress.
Today's topic is new rules. Right. So you might all have been utilized the news. You may be aware, and I hope that I assure that at least you will come to know the today's in today's session. At least you will come to know minimum 10 new points in new rules. So that is my assurance. We'll start one by one. So actually, what is leave? So in my view, leave is it's entertainment, health, and wealth. So if anybody have the entertainment in their life, health in their life, and wealth in their life, they can enjoy their life. They can lead their life, enjoy it. Right? How it is entertainment? If I want to attend my brother-in-law's marriage, or I want to attend my childbirth, so at this time, employee will feel more happy. And if he want to attend any domestic reasons, or to attend his personal work, or he want to proceed on abroad to witness the somebody's enjoyment. So once he is sanctioned with the leave, he can meet his family members and friends, and he can lead his personal life. So I say leave is entertainment. Then come to health. If you fall sick and you have been assumed with the some responsibilities, and with the some illness, you cannot perform your job perfectly. So if you have been sanctioned with the leave, with the salary, with the payment, so you can get well soon, and you can refresh yourself. And once you refresh, you can execute your duties with more dedication. So I say it is a leave means it is a entertainment and health. Now come to wealth. So if you accumulate your leave balance without availing any leaves, so you all are aware that during service you may encash your leaves for the 6 times, and at the end of your service, at the cessation of your service, you can encashment the leave to the tune of 300 days. So I say leave means it is entertainment and it is the life actually. So to lead our personal life, to balance our personal life and official life, so everyone should have some kinds of leave in their job. So it's entertainment, health, and wealth. You will get money, you will get health, you can cure your illnesses during leave period, so on. So now come to what is leave? What is the definition of leave? Leave means it's a authority or permission granted by the employer to the employee. Without the leave, without granting permission or leave, you cannot leave your headquarters also. You should be available on duty for 24/7 hours. Once you have been granted with the leave, you can proceed and you can leave your headquarters, and you will be keep away from your bona fide duties. You will not be disturbed to attend the duties during the leave period unless until it warrants the public interest. It warrants the purely in public interest. As I said, grant of leave will not only benefit the employee. Some people may be in view that the grant of leave is beneficial to the employee only. So it is wrong. Grant of leave or sanctioning of leave will be beneficial to both the employee as well as the employer also. How? When somebody come to me as a sanctioning authority, comes to me once, I say that how many cases are pending? आपके पास कितना pending है? You clear that all the pending cases, I will sanction the leave. So to sanction the leave for one day or two days, sometimes I put him to exhibit his all the, to clear all the his pending files. And once sanctioned also, I will take a assurance from the employee that after coming back, you should do that work and this work like that. I take the promise from the employee and I sanction the leave. So leave is a authority of permission granted to the employee by the employer of sanctioning authority, and the grant of the leave will be beneficial to both the employee as well as the employer also, right? So kinds of leave rules to railway employees. So we all are enjoying the leave rules, but some people doesn't know the name of the leave rules, nomenclature of the leave rules which we are enjoying. So earlier, presently we are enjoying the railway services liberalized leave rules. You can underline the liberalized, right? Earlier to this, there are company leave rules and state leave rules. So these liberalized leave rules, railway services liberalized leave rules are came in force with effect from 1 to 1949. And in green I have mentioned the, I have mentioned some paragraphs also. So this is the paragraph, if you refer that paragraph, you will come to know the entire description of that leave rules or something, right? So these leave rules are briefly discussed in chapter 5 of IRES volume 1. Indian Railway Establishment Code Volume 1, Chapter 5, in Chapter 5 these reviews are briefly discussed. So we will see how it is liberalized. Liberalized means it is so common, so common. So we will see one by one. Right, then come to applicable to all the railway employees, railway servants who are joined on or after 1-2-1949. So we all are, those who are working in railways at present, they all are comes under the purview of railway services liberalized leave rules 1949 only. And the most important thing is that leave you cannot claim as a matter of right. So it is up to the sanctioning authority in the interest of public interest, in the public interest, your leave may be cancelled. It can be revoked or it may be reduced also. But it is not open to the sanctioning authority to alter one kind of leave to another kind. If suppose I applied for a LAP of 20 days, so my leave sanctioning authority cannot alter my leave to LHP. You take the LHP. So that right cannot be, it is not possible to the sanctioning authority. But employee cannot claim as a matter of right. But in case of maternity leave and paternity leave, we cannot reject. This leave sanctioning authority cannot reject the maternity leave and paternity leave. So leave is not a matter of right, it is a para 503. And counting of previous leave balance in case of any break in service is there due to technical resignation. Some people who they appoint in railways and they may quit the railways and they may join another service of the central government, same central government service. Those are enjoying the similar type of leave rules. Their leave balance, whatever they put in railways, will be carried forward in their new service. In case of reinstatement of the service also, the employee is eligible to carry forward their leave balance which is available in their account prior to their dismissal or removal or dismissal or removal from the service. chart box also, right? Then counting of previous balance, it is discussed in para 504. And conversion of one kind of leave to another kind is permissible within 1 month from the date of reporting from leave on request of the employee before he retires. Some people, where we are getting a request from the employees stating that I have availed LHAP or EOL leave without pay, extraordinary leave during 1995. Now you convert it to LHAP. That is not at all permissible. We should not encourage others. What rule says the conversion of one kind of leave to another kind is permissible within 1 month from the date he reports back to duty after expiry of such leave. So after lapse of months together and years together, employee should not be that conversion of leave to one kind to another kind should not be permissible. And employee should be in service. Once the employee retires, his all the accounts will be settled, all the settlement benefits will be settled. So once the employee retires, his conversion of leave, one kind of leave to another kind of leave, is not at all permissible. This is a very, very, very important, because we deal, personal and accounts department deals with the leave sheets, leave accounts. So we should be very careful. Some of the technical branches, as they are not much aware of these rules, they sanction on their own and they send the requests for conversion of one kind of leave to another kind of leave after lapse of months and years. That should not be permissible as per the rule number 505 of IRAC volume 5, chapter 5 of IRAC volume 1. Right? Then you all are aware that prefixed and suffixed holidays, right, except in case of special CL and CL, the holidays will be treated as a duty. Suppose one employee is office days or office working days are from Monday to Friday, and those who enjoys the Saturday and the Sunday, if he wants to avail the leave from Monday, then that Saturday and the Sunday will be treated as a duty work. If he avails leave up to Friday, and if he reports duty on Monday, then that Saturday, Sunday after expiry of that leave sanctioning period also will be treated as duty work. In case of holidays falls between the leave period, will be counted as leave work. Right? Then during the leave sanctioning period, during the leave period, no one should, no railway servant, he cannot take any employment during the leave period. Why? Because we are paying the leave salary to the employee, and the maximum of amount of leave that can be sanctioned to any employee is maximum 5 years, including all the kinds of leave applicable to or due to the employee. Suppose I have five employees, all the five employees who are working under me, and I am the sanctioning authority, leave sanctioning authority. All the five have submitted the leave application at a time and for the same period. I cannot sanction to all the employees, right? And I cannot close my shed. So for that, for the sanctioning of the leave sanctioning also, there is some priority has been designed. That is, so if all the five have submitted, I have to see that best can be spared. So, jisko main leave sanction karke usse bhi main kaam chala raha sakta hu. So, there he can be sanctioned with the leave. Then, after that, I have to see whether the leave balance of the employee, and the higher balance of the employee should be given the priority. And then, third point is quality of service he rendered after availing the last leave. Then, if compulsorily recalled from leave. Compulsorily means if you have been seen that one of the in the movies, many of the movies in Telugu movies, Hindi movies also, one of the army person grants leave, first he grants leave and he, once he enjoying with his family, suddenly he gets some phone call or some message that he should join the force immediately. So he is recalling from the leave. He is recalling from the leave. If anybody is compulsorily recalled from earlier sanctioned leave to the duty in the interest of public, so he should be given priority. Then leave refused in public interest. If any time, any pentaxial time, if he has been refused with the leave earlier, he is requested. In that case also, in this, as per this priority only, we have to, by sanctioning the leave, we have to see these priorities.
Thank you.
Okay, sorry, some disturbance due to technical reasons, right? So, if you recall from duty within the India, if you are sanctioned leave and recalled from the duty, recalled to duty before expiry of a leave, so employee eligible for this, the entire period of journey will be treated as a duty, and employee is eligible for the traveling allowance also. In case of outside of India, journey period will be on duty, airfare to India, duty pass and PA should be allowed. And if the employee has not completed his 50% of sanctioned leave or 3 months, whichever is shorter, 50% of sanctioned leave or 3 months, whichever is shorter, in that case, we have to, government has to bear the airfare from the India also. So employee should be reimbursed with the airfare voucher and it was cost which he has occurred while proceeding to abroad. These are the rules for recalling to the duty before expiry of the leave, right? And this is very important that willful absence from duty after the expiry of leave liable to disciplinary action. Even one day of absence also may lead to disciplinary action against the employee. So willful option will be treated as a sufficient reason to issue the charge sheet to the employee, even one day also. Right? Then kinds of leaves admissible to the railway servants. Right? You may be familiar with these all these leaves. Right? One LAP, LHAP, committed leave, leave not due, LND, and extraordinary leave, leave to apprentices, maternity leave, adoptive mother, paternity leave, adoptive father, study leave, ex-India leave, child care leave. And this is very important that WRIIL, most of you may not be aware of this, right? Work-related injury and illness leave. This leave is introduced with effect from 14-12-2018 and duly omitting the earlier special disability leave and hospital leave. So that's why I have not mentioned the hospital leave and the special disability leave. Hospital leave and special disability leave has become a history, right? Then CL, casual leave and special CL, then joining time, and encashment of leave while in service and on cessation of service. These are the leave, kinds of leave admissible to the railway servants, right? Then we will see in next slides one by one. Then come to leave on average pay. Leave on average pay. You all are familiar about this leave on average pay. So this LAP is briefly discussed in paragraph 523, 524 and 525 of IREC. So all the railway servants except school staff are eligible for 30 days of LAP in a calendar year, right? You all are aware that 15 days in advance you should underline and you should note it. 15 days in advance on 1st January and 1st July of every year. 15 days credit in advance on 1st January and 1st July of every year. I said it is other than the are eligible for only 10 days in a calendar year, that is 5 days in advance credit on 1st January or on 1st days, and another 5 days on 1st July. And the school staff earlier, they are not at all entitled or eligible for the LAP prior to 14-12-2018. I have mentioned the RBE number also. RBE number also I have mentioned. RBE 16-4-2019, as per that, school staff are eligible for the 10 days of LAP in a calendar year, and 5 days should be credited on, in advance should be credited on 1st January, and another 5 days on 1st July. Right? In LAP, previous leave balance will be carried forward. You all are aware that it will be carried forward, and the maximum accumulation of LAP is 300 days. Maximum accumulation is 300 days. Suppose if I have 300 days of LAP balance, I cannot avail all the new LAP at a time. There is a maximum limit of the grant of LAP at a time is restricted to 180 days only. It is restricted to 180 days of LAP can be availed at a time by any employee irrespective of his, if he has a more balance also, leave balance, LAP balance also, he can avail only 180 days only. Then crediting of LAP. LAP, as I said, it is credited on in advance on 1st January and 1st July at the rate of 15 days each. But in case if anyone is appointed after 1st January or 1st July, then how we are to credit? It is very simple that for each completed calendar month, it is very important that each completed calendar month, for each completed calendar month, we have to credit 2.5 days of LAP in advance. Suppose anybody is joined on as on today. Today is the 26th of July. So employee is joined today. So he is not completing the entire calendar month of July. So he is not entitled for the credit for the month of July. And for remaining 5 months, he will be credited at the rate of 2.5 days each completed calendar month. For each completed calendar month, employee is eligible for the 2.5 days at the rate of 2.5 days. So he should be credited with the 12.5 days. So it should be rounded off, not up. Rounded, it's not given rounded up. It is rounded off to the nearest day. So he should be credited with the 12 days of LAP. Suppose if any of the employees joined in service today, because he is not completing the full calendar month for the month of July, he is not entitled for the leave credit for the month of July. Right? While in service, as already discussed, the regular employee will be credited 15 days each on 1st January and 1st July. In the case of retirement or resignation, if any of the employees is retiring in this month, on 38th of July, if any of the employees is retiring, so he is putting only 1 month, one full calendar month service only. So he will be credited with the, on the 1st July, he will be credited with the 2.5 days of LAP, because it should be rounded off to the nearest day. So he will be credited with the 2 days of LAP only. In case of removal or dismissal or death while in service, if anyone is supposedly expired on today, 26th, he is expired or removed or dismissed service. So he is not entitled for the leave credit for the month of July. Till June only, his leave account should be credited till June only, because he has not completed the full calendar month service. So he is should not be credited the leave for the month of July. So this is the crediting of leave while at the initial stage, appointment, while in service, and at the time of cessation of service, retirement or resignation. If anyone completes full calendar month, then the employee is entitled for the full leave of for that period only. So we are crediting in advance, as I have already informed that in advance should be underlined or should be noted. So we are crediting in advance. months for the 6 months leave, that 15 days of leave in advance, stating that or treating that employee will be regular to the duty. Regular to the duty, he will execute his duties properly without any non-qualifying service. If suppose anybody remained absent for some 30 days of service, 30 days service, so his leave balance should be debited. His leave balance also should be debited as we have credited in advance. For a LAP, we have to debit 1/10 of the 1/10 multiplied by the number of days. We have to multiply the number of days of the absence period. Then that debit should be raised as against the leave balance of the employee. Suppose if anybody remained absent for 160 days, and he remained present only for 20 days, 1/10 divided by 160, it will arrive to 16 days. As we have credited only 15 days, can we deduct 16 days of LAP? So we should not deduct more than the maximum restriction is 15 days we have to deduct. And already we have discussed that the fraction of days should be rounded off. It is not rounded up. Please note that it is not rounded up like DA. When DA figure, DA or some of our pay reaches after 55, more than 55, then it should be rounded off up to the next rupee. It's not like that. It should be rounded off to the nearest day. So while sanctioning, if any employee is sanctioned with the LAP, the employee is eligible for the full payment as we have drawn on average pay, right? And the more interesting thing is, workshop staff are eligible for half day of LAP. Workshop staff are eligible for half day LAP also. If suppose Saturday is half day working, then if employee applies for the half day LAP on Saturday, if workshop staff is apply for the half day LAP, it should be treated as a full day only. And the most important thing, while you are applying your LAP, in your LAP application, you might have been observed that reaching, when you have completed length of service, what the length of service you have completed, when you are reaching the age of 50 years, when you are reaching the age of 55 years. It may be that because that the leave sanctioning authority, those who are in the last 10 years of service, for the employees, those who are in the last 10 years of service, their leave cannot be rejected ordinarily. Without, unless until there is a strong reason, the leave sanctioning authority, for the employees, those who have more than 50 years of age, their leave cannot be rejected ordinarily. It should be strong reason. Then come to, that's about LAP, and come to leave on after pay. If you already understood the LAP, so it will be very easy to understand the LHAP also. So for LHAP, 20 days in a calendar year to all the railway servants other than school staff, right? Prior to 14-12-2018, the railway staff are also eligible for 20 days of LHAP, leave on average pay. After 14-12-2018, RBE number 64/2019, the railway school staff are not eligible for, not entitled for the LHAP. They are not at all entitled for the LHAP of 20 days. Instead of 20 days of LHAP, they were allowed with the 10 days of LAP. So 10 days in advance, it's a simple that 20 divided by 2, 10 days in advance on 1st January and 1st July of every year. School staff no credit. Previous balance will be carried forward as it was discussed for LAP. And there is no limit in accumulation. Whereas the limit for accumulation of LAP is 300 days, and in the case of LHAP, there is no limit in accumulation. and the maximum of 24 months can be granted at a time. Maximum of LHRB can be granted at a time. So in case of LAP, it is only 180 days. In case of LHRB, it is maximum can be granted is 24 months. And the crediting of LHRB, it's very simple that 20 divided by 12. If you make a 20 divided by 12, it will arrive to 5/3. So LHRB shall be credited in advance at the rate of 5/3 days for each completed calendar month, as it was LAP only. For each completed calendar month, it should be noted that for each completed calendar month, and while in service also, while in service for 10 days each on the 1st January and 1st July. And in case of retirement or resignation, for each completed calendar month, 5/3 days will be credited. In case of removal or dismissal also, same scenario, for each completed calendar month, it will be credited at the rate of 5/3 days, right? And it should be rounded off to the nearest figure. And the debit is, if anybody remained absent or unauthorized absent or the service which does not qualify as a qualifying service during the previous half year, the credit shall be reduced to 1/18 of the period of the EOL or absence of the, and the maximum is restricted to 10 days only. As we are crediting 10 days of maximum of 10 days of LHRB, the debit should also be restricted to the 10 days only. And while LHRB, you all are aware that you are eligible for only half pay only. If you are trying 30,000 of basic pay and you are remained the full month of on leave for the LHRB leave for the full month, then you are eligible for only 15,000 of, that is half pay of, half average pay of your salary. So you will get 15,000 rupees basic pay and allowances there. So in the case of LHRB, you will get the full salary. And the most important thing is that some of we are in the view that LHRB should be granted for the purpose of sick only. It is wrong. It is wrong. The LHRB can be granted on medical certificate as well as on private FIs also for whatever reason. You may, while during sanction of LHRB, you may attend marriage, you may attend your domestic work, any purpose, for any purpose you may request for the sanction of the LHRB. Most of the employees are in view that LHRB is meant only for the sick. That is not correct. Please. So then come to committed leave. So committed leave will be granted or sanctioned on production of medical fit and sick certificate, on production of medical certificate only. So employees should return to duty after expiry of committed leave, right? During the committed leave period, the employee will get the full payment as on par with LAP. As in the case of LAP, employee will get the full amount. Only thing is, the double the amount of LHRB balance will be debited from his salary, from his leave account. So not exceeding the half the amount of LHRB. If I have only 50 days of LHRB balance at my credit, only 50 days of LHRB balance at my credit. So commutation of leave, maximum of commutation of leave can be sanctioned is 25 days only. I can commute maximum of 25 days because I have only 50 days of leave balance. So on production of medical sick and fit certificate, employee should return to duty after expiry of committed leave. Twice the amount of LHRB will be debited and paid full salary. As we have discussed, for LHRB, normally we have to pay only half salary only. 50% of your salary should be paid. As we are debiting twice the amount of LHRB, you will get the full amount of leave salary, full amount of leave salary. no limit in entire service, no limit in entire service, and 180 days can be sanctioned on study leave. 180 days of commutation of leave can be sanctioned on study leave. If the employee, here we have said that once the employee is sanctioned with the committed leave, he should return back to duty after expiry of the committed leave. If the employee resigns or VR without returning to duty, should be treated as LHAP and the difference amount should be recorded from the employee. If the employee on his own violation resigns the service or takes VR on his own violation, then the entire period of commutation of leave will be treated as LHAP and the difference of amount, whatever amount you have paid towards the committed leave, that is 50% of his salary, should be recovered from his settlement benefits or something. If the case, in the case of employee resigns his service or terminating his service in case of resignation or VR on medical incapacitation or medical incapacitation, then on death of the employee, we should not recover the commutation of leave amount. This is the about the commutation of leave, and you may refer para 526 of the 527 of IRAC volume 1. Then come to leave not due. Leave not due. If you refer the name, the name itself is saying that leave not due. You don't have any balance of leave in your account. You don't have any balance of your leave account, and you are suffering with the some serious illness, and you are not receiving any salary because you don't have the LAP balance at your credit and the LHAP balance at your credit. How your family will survive? You cannot survive. Your family will not survive, right? And if your family is struggling and you are facing some illness, so you may not get well soon. You may not get well soon. That's why the leave rules are called. Even you don't have the leave balance also, any kind of leave balance also, and you are seriously suffering with some illness and taking treatment at some government hospital or railway hospital, at that time also, railway will pay you some amount. Railway will pay you some amount to survive your family and yourself and to get well soon. It is a moral support to the family. That's why the nomenclature of leave rules itself says it is a liberalized leave rules. Right? So permanent, to whom I have to sanction leave not due? Permanent railway employee with minimum 1 year of service. The railway employees who have rendered minimum 1 year of service, and when no kind of leave balance to the employee, and on production of medical certificate, for any other purpose we will not sanction the leave not due. So, kitna amount sanction karna hai leave not due ka? Total 360 days in entire service. In entire service. Are limited to the LHAP likely to earn. Railway kya karega? When you don't have the leave balance, you will be sanctioned with the leave not due and you will pay the 50% of your salary. Should be debited against a future LHAP credit of payment de dega. Agar if you are basic salary is basic pay is 30,000. During leave not due, you will get 50,000 of basic pay and other allowances on that. So, once you have been get well soon, you have reported back to duty. Then, the amount of leave not due sanctioned to the employee will be adjusted against the future credit of the LHAP credit of the employee. Suppose one of the employee is having only 1 year of service. He is at the age of 59 and 1 year of service is left over. So maximum LHAP credit he may get is earn is only 20 days only in his service. So if I sanction 360 days of LND to him, so it will be lost to the railways. So it is restricted to maximum 300 days. Or the limited to LHAP conjunction with the maximum 20 days of leave not due only. If anybody, any of the employees so young and his remaining service is 20 years and in remaining 20 years if he serves 5 years regularly, he may earn 400 days of LHIP at his credit. So in such case, the employee can be sanctioned with the maximum of 360 days of L&T in entire service. In entire service, as he may earn more than 360 days of LHIP at his credit during his service after resuming to duty. So L&T permanent employee with 1 year service को देना है. When कोई leave balance नहीं बचा रहना है, LAP नहीं रहना, LHIP नहीं रहना, on production of medical certificate and maximum is 360 days or the LHIP likely to end in his service after resumption of duty and should be debited against future LHIP credit of payment दे देंगे as it was paid for the LHIP. It is like accommodation of leave also. It is also same. If the employee एक बार वो उसका illness अच्छा हो गया and once he resumes duty and if he gets a good opportunity in private industry, if he quits the railways or he takes a VR on his own, then the employee has to repay the entire cost of the entire leave salary of the leave not due. If he resigns or before he ends such kind of leave, right? If the employee resigns for VR on medical incapacitation or death or no, then no recovery. No recovery should be made in that case. So that's why the leave rules are called liberalized leave rules. Agar commutation leave not due bhi khatam ho gaya. Leave not due bhi khatam ho gaya. Employee ka 360 days of leave also exhausted and the still employee is suffering with some illness under the treatment, then on our railway, on SCR railway, South Central Railway, from SBF, Staff Benefit Fund, we are paying 5,000 rupees per month to the family of the employee. So this is for the only for in South Central Railway only. So this is about committed leave and the leave not due. Then come to extraordinary leave. In leave rules, there is no mention, nowhere mentioned it is a leave without pay. Leave without pay, absent without pay, sick without pay. No such such nomenclature is mentioned in entire leave rules of the Railway Services Liberalized Leave Rules 1949. Right? It should be named as extraordinary leave. Extraordinary leave. It should be called as extraordinary leave. When employee can be sanctioned with the extraordinary leave, EOL or extraordinary leave, when no kind of leave is available at his credit, then no leave of any kind of leave is available at his credit, or if the employee is available with the leave of sufficient balance of LAP and LHIP, but employee requests for sanction of the EOL when no kind of leave is available, and if the employee is having sufficient balance of LAP or LHIP also, employee can be sanctioned if he requests for EOL, extraordinary leave, the employee can be sanctioned with the extraordinary leave. Permanent employee ko, we can sanction maximum of 5 years of leave, including all kinds of leave due to him. We can sanction maximum of 5 years of leave, including all the kinds of leaves attributable to him. And the only thing is, it is a permission to keep away from his bona fide duties, and the employee will not get any pay and allowances during the period of EOL. Extraordinary leave ka period mein, the employee will not get any payment, even single paisa bhi nahi milega usko, right? So it is only the permission granted to the employee to keep away from his official duties, right? And the EOL period with the medical certificate supporting with the EOL sanction, extraordinary leave sanction on support of medical certificate, it's a couple of increments in new credit and so the employee is eligible for the that service will be counted as a qualified service for all the purpose in case it is supported by medical certificate. Otherwise that service will not be counted as a qualifying service for any purpose, right? In case of, I said that in case of permanent employee, we may sanction maximum of 5 years of leave, including all kinds of leave. In case of temporary railway servant, 3 months without a medical certificate and 6 months with a medical certificate. If any of the temporary railway servant is suffering with TB, cancer or leprosy, in that case 18 months of extraordinary leave can be sanctioned. In case of higher studies, 24 months of extraordinary leave can be sanctioned. Then come to leave to apprentices. Okay, special class railway apprentices. Those are mechanical officers who appointed special class railway apprentices. Now it is not there. If they are entitled for 30 days of full stipend, as the apprentices or trainees will draw the stipend only. They are not entitled for the salary. So they are eligible for with full stipend 30 days of leave and half stipend nil. These half stipend should be supported with the medical certificate. When you are sanctioning half stipend leave, it should be supported with the medical certificate only. Apprentice mechanics in workshops, those who are undergoing training like the CG apprentice, those in workshop, they are entitled for 16 days of full stipend leave and 20 days of half stipend leave. In a calendar year, all the leaves are in a calendar year only. Then other apprentices, other than workshop apprentices, they are entitled for 12 days of full stipend leave and 15 days of half stipend leave. This is with regard to extraordinary leave and leave to the apprentices. Then come to maternity leave. It's a very interesting thing, right? So a female railway servant, either permanent, temporary or apprentice, any female railway servant who is working on railways with less than 2 surviving children, this sentence should be understood clearly. This sentence. With less than 2 surviving children, with less than 2 surviving children is the main criteria for sanctioning the maternity leave. Some people are in view that maternity leave should be sanctioned only 2 times of entire service of the female railway servant. It is wrong. It is linked with the less than 2 surviving children. If you have less than 2 surviving children, the railway servant, female railway servant, can be sanctioned with maternity leave for any number of times till she satisfies this condition. With less than 2 surviving children condition, the female railway servant has to be sanctioned with the maternity leave of 180 days of maternity leave in a single spell. Some people ask that, sir, I will have 30 days before confinement or delivery, and after delivery I will take some days, I will attend the office, and after delivery please sanction me another remaining 3 months of maternity leave. Nothing doing. So the maternity leave should be sanctioned in a single spell on production of medical certificate. On production of medical certificate. Some people may take leave before 10 days or 15 days of their confinement, or some people may be due to their ill health, or some people have to take rest, bed rest, complete bed rest before a delivery of 3 months or 4 months. So in that case, on production of medical certificate, on the recommendation of medical authority, railway medical authority, we have to sanction the maternity leave of 180 days of the maternity leave to a female railway servant. Here again I am mentioning that a female railway servant. Here we have not mentioned whether it is married, unmarried, or divorced, or widowed. We are just simply mentioning a female railway servant. So what rule says is even a unmarried female railway servant, if she is going for whatever reasons it may be, if she is going for confinement or delivery, if she is carrying, whatever the reasons it may be, a female railway servant, here we are not mentioning she is married or unmarried, then even unmarried female railway servant is also to be sanctioned with the 180 days of maternity leave, whether she is permanent, temporary or apprentice. That 180 days should be sanctioned with the in a single span. Only thing is that she should satisfy the condition that she should have the at the time of confinement, she should have the less than two surviving children. If she has less than two surviving children, then the employee is eligible for the 180 days of maternity leave. Right? It can be combined with any other kind of leave. 6 months of maternity leave, it can be combined with LAP. If she has the LAP balance, it can be combined with the CCF, it can be combined with the LHAP, and it can be combined with the commutation of leave also. Right? So 60 days of commutation of leave and maximum up to 2 years of leave. Maximum 2 years of leave on medical or maternity leave can be sanctioned. Maximum leave up to 2 years means any other kind of leaves, including 180 days of maternity leave and including any other kind of leave such as LAP, LHAP or CCL. Right? ML followed by EOL, extraordinary leave, sometimes maternity leave, and they immediately request without medical certificate. Extraordinary leave without a medical certificate does not count as a qualifying service. No debit against the leave balance. Koi balance se se leave balance se debit nahi kar raha hai. LAP, LHAP balance se debit nahi kar raha. And the full payment during the entire period of maternity leave. As we pay for the LAP, leave on average pay pe jo pay karega, full pay karna hai karna hai ML. That entire period of ML will be treated as a duty and it will be treated as a qualifying service for the purpose of annual increment and for the purpose of crediting of leave balance also, right? In case of stillborn child, stillborn matlab delivery hote hi bachcha agar guzar gaya to, if the boy or koi bachcha janm lete hi guzar gaya, if expires, newborn baby expires, then it is called stillborn child. And in case of female who has, in that case also we have to extend the maternity leave. Maternity leave. Yeah, देखिए एक example ले लीजिए. कोई एक female railway servant at the first instance of her pregnancy, she blessed with one child. एक बच्चा को जन्म लिया है, one child blessed with suppose twins, blessed with the twins, right? दो बच्चों को जन्म दिया है and now she is going for another issue, delivery. यहाँ देखिए that maternity leave should be sanctioned when the employee is having less than two surviving children. Twins है ना, दो जिंदा ही है, both are surviving. So is that employee is satisfying this condition? Less than two surviving children is not satisfying. It is equal to the two surviving children. In that case, employee is not eligible for the maternity leave. In case any of the employees already having one child and going for another child, as she is satisfying the condition of less than one surviving children at the time of confinement, she can be sanctioned with the maternity leave of 180 days. And after उसके बाद सेकंड टाइम मैटरनिटी लीव में सी इज ब्लेस्ड विद द वन बेबी and the baby is survived for 3 years. After 3 years, that one of the babies expired some reason, due to some reason. So again, employee is going for carrying and going for delivery. As one out of two babies, one baby is already expired. So she is going for the another issue. So at the time of confinement, she is having less than 2 surviving children also only. So those the employees already avail the 2 types of maternity leave, because one child is expired after 2 to 3 years of service, right? So now she is going for third issue, but only surviving children is only less than 2 surviving children is there. Then the employee is eligible for the another 180 days of maternity leave. Okay. Part time also, if the employee is delivered with the stillborn child, paida hota hi baby is expired. So if she is going for fourth batch, right? As she is having less than 2 surviving children, the employee is again eligible for the fourth time also. She is eligible for the 180 days of maternity leave. Till such time she satisfies with the this condition, with the less than 2 surviving children condition, she should be sanctioned with the maternity leave of 180 days and any number of times, right? So agar ek employee, female railway servant, she is unmarried, and but she married she got married with a employee, with a person who is already having 2 surviving children with his previous wife. Say ek aadmi ko, one employee married a widower with children from his former wife. So already 2 surviving children have, they will be called as a stepchild, stepson or stepdaughter, stepchildren to the railway employee, female railway servant. And she is going for third issue on her own delivery ke liye ja raha. At that time also, we have to sanction the maternity leave, because the earlier 2 children are, they are not natural children to the lady, right? They are not natural to the female employee. That's why the female employee is eligible for the, even though she is having many number of stepchildren, as she is going on his own account, so she should be sanctioned with the maternity leave on his own account, right? And in addition to the maternity leave, female railway servants are eligible for 45 days of abortion leave. 45 days of, most of us may not be aware of this, 45 days of abortion leave in entire service of the female railway servant, if in case of any miscarriage or any in case of miscarriage or abortion. So 45 days in addition to the maternity leave, the female railway servant is eligible for the 45 days of abortion leave in entire service of her service. This is about the maternity leave. If you understood the maternity leave concept, right, the concept of with less than 2 surviving children concept, then paternity leave will be very easy. It is very clearly mentioned in rule that you cannot, the leave sanctioning authority cannot reject the maternity leave. When you, if you receive medical authority's recommendation that the employee is unable to attend her physical official duties, then the employee should be sanctioned in any way. Employee should be sanctioned with the maternity leave, and the maternity leave cannot be rejected like other kinds of leave like LAP, LHP, CM. Okay, then come to paternity leave. So in case of a male railway servant, again I am repeating that I am mentioning only male railway servant. I am not mentioning whether he is married, widower or widow, right? So a male railway servant having less than 2 surviving children, whether permanent, temporary or apprentice, right, with less than 2 surviving children, if he is satisfying the less than 2 surviving children condition, they should be sanctioned with the 15 days of paternity in a single spell. In a single spell, can be combined with any other kind of leave. And during the confinement, why it is called liberalized leave rules? In each leave, you will come to know why it is liberalized, right? One way, if your wife is admitted in hospital, right? If anybody's wife is admitted in hospital, and you will be drafted for duty, some official duty, so can you peacefully execute your duty? You cannot. So to attend your wife's illness or confinement, and to enjoy the fathership, your fathership or mothership, right? So you will be sanctioned with the leave. So 15 days of paternity leave in a single spell, and can be combined with any kind of leave. Kabul hai. So can I take the leave some 6 months before the confinement of my wife? So I cannot. So it should be sanctioned prior to 15 days. Or within 6 months of the birth of the child. Right? Why government is sanctioning, you know, right? We have to vaccinate the child properly. So for the purpose of vaccination, for the purpose of illness of the child, or to give the moral support to the wife of the railway employee, railway sanctions 15 days of paternity leave. Or to enjoy the fathership or parenthood, the railway sanctions the 15 days of paternity leave, and it should not be debited from your leave account balance, and the full payment during the paternity leave. As it is said already, for the in case of female employee, in the case of male employee also, if he has married with a widow or from widow with the children from her former husband. Already dusra shaadi se aur dusra way mein kuch bacche hai to already lady ko bacche hai, but our railway employee is married that lady with the stepchildren, then also the employee on his own, agar confinement delivery ko ja raha to the railway employee is eligible for the paternity leave of 15 days if he satisfies the condition of less than 2 surviving children condition at the time of confinement of his wife. This is about maternity leave and paternity leave. If you understood the maternity leave and paternity leave, then the maternity leave for adoptive mother. If some people, unfortunately, some of the railway employee or male railway employee, they have not blessed with any children. They are not blessed with any children. Are blessed with a child, single child, and they are going for adoption. Legal adoption. It should be a valid adoption. Valid is the important point. I cannot say that I have adopted some people for like that, without a valid documentation, without a valid proof of adoption, we should not sanction the adoption leave. So maternity leave, a female railway servant, here also I am not mentioning married, unmarried, or widower, right? It should be a female railway servant, permanent, temporary, or apprentice with less than 2 surviving children. If they are already having 2 surviving children, they may go for the adoption, but they are not eligible for paternity leave, right? So on valid adoption, if the child's age is 15 years and they are going to be adopted at 15 years, boy who is studying 10th class, can we sanction the maternity leave? So maternity leave is for the purpose to take care of the child. 15 saal bachcha ko kya care lega mother? Mother ka care bachcha lega 15 saal. So if the child age is below 1 year of age, if the child age is, the adoptive child age is 1 year below, then the mother can be sanctioned with 180 days of maternity leave on par with the children. There is no difference between natural mother and the adoptive mother. Only condition is that the employee should satisfy the condition of with less than two surviving children. If any employee is having already one child, and if he has already availed maternity leave, and now she is going for the second child adoption, on production of legal valid adoption, and you may aware that only Hindus can adopt the child. Only the Hindus personal law allows to adopt the child. Right? As per the Hindu Adoption Act 1971, only Hindus can adopt the child. So on production of valid adoption and less than 1 year age of child, if the 1 year child age is less than 1 year, then the leave sanctioning authority can sanction 180 days of maternity leave on par with the natural mother. No debit against the leave balance and the full payment during the maternity leave. And here very important thing is that the surrogacy mothers are not eligible for the maternity leave because of khudka account na ye. Right? Surrogacy means it is the some people gives their what we call for rent. Right? Koi rent pe bachcha paida kar rahe ho. Right? Surrogacy mothers. You might be seen in the newspapers on somewhere. Right? Surrogacy mothers are not entitled for the maternity leave because it is not their own account, on their own account. Right? So this is about the maternity leave and adoptive mother. In the same way, paternity leave to the father also. Agar mother ko diya to father ko kyun nahi dena hai? So father is also eligible for the a male railway servant with less than two surviving children. Only thing is paternity leave mein kitna baar bhi de sakte hai apan. Only they should satisfy the condition of less than two surviving children condition only, and on valid adoption duty. Child age is less than 1 year only. Less than 1 year bachcha koi dena hai. If they are adopting more than 1 year of child, then they are not eligible for the paternity leave. No debit against the leave balance, full payment during the paternity leave. That's why our leave rules are called liberalized leave rules. I am again repeating the same point. Right? Then come to study leave. Study leave may be where so many views, these things are there. Some of the employees in view that for any purpose of study they can be sanctioned with the study leave. So agar I am working as a APO, right? I am working as assistant personal officer, right? Mera kaam kya hai, main track pe kaam nahi karta. I will not work on track. I will work for the human resources maintain karta hu, salary payment karta hu. If I am going for the LLB degree, main agar LLB karna chahta hu, which is beneficial to the administration, right? If I go for the MBA, it's a human resource management, main MBA karna chahta hu, agar wo administration ko fayda hai. Main track pe kaam nahi karta hu, if I go for a diploma in civil engineering, right, or BTech in civil engineering, Will it be beneficial to the railway administration? No. In such type, so such condition, we should not sanction with the study leave. So study leave kisko dena hai? If the course is directly and closely connected with the sphere of official duty, agar koi PWA, SSC PWA, JE PWA, if he is working on track, and that if he pursue his higher qualification or certification in civil engineering, it will be beneficial to the railway administration in the public interest. So he can be spared on study leave. He can be spared on study leave to pursue his study. Right? Agar koi doctor hai, already he is a MBBS. Now he is going for MBA, that's all. Can we sanction study leave? No. If he is going for PG in some cardiac, neurologist ko jara, ophthalmologist ko jara, we can permit him. Pediatrics ko jara. So, wo kuch fayda rehna hai. Administration ka account mein fayda hai, no? We can admit the or I we can permit the employee to prosecute his IR studies in the subjects which is closely connected with the sphere of his official duties. His official duties only. And kisko dena hai? A railway employee with minimum 5 years of regular service, including probation. A permanent railway employee with minimum of 5 years of service, including probation period. And he should not be due for superannuation. Agar koi banda ko main PG degree ko bhija raha hu, he is due for retirement within 1 year. 59 years ka age hai. I sent him for official, uska official closely related hai, SSCP mein hai. And I am directing him to prosecute the higher studies in diploma in civil engineering. Ek saal mein retire ho raha, can we permit him? So we should not permit him. So employee should not be in for superannuation within 3 years after completion of course of study. Right? So should execute a bond to the railways to serve minimum period of 3 years. Agar koi achha course kar liya, that is full demand in the private market. Course karne ke baad, he says that I am quitting the railways. After enjoying all the benefits of study, you will pay. Now he is saying that I am quitting the service. Usko hum, so he cannot quit the service with, unless until he serves the railways for a minimum period of 3 years after completion of that service. And he should execute a bond that I am assuring that I will serve the railways a minimum period of 3 years after completion of study. In case of doctors, they should serve the railways a minimum 5 years of service, right? ये कोई अच्छा neurologist बन गया, बहुत बार बहुत market है, so I can quit the service बन गया तो नहीं, so he should before proceeding on the study leave, the employee should execute a bond stating that I will serve the railways for a minimum period of 3 years in case of normal employee, in case of doctors 5 years, and कितना what the amount of study leave can be sanctioned to the railway employee, right? 12 months at a time and the maximum restricted to 24 months. Maximum of study leave can be sanctioned to the employee or granted to the employee. Railway, permanent railway servant is maximum is 24 months only. In case of doctors, then unka PG 3 saal ka rehta hai. Their PG course is 3 years. That why doctor is permitted to 36 months of maximum of study leave can be sanctioned, right? And during the study leave of the employee is eligible for the all the leave salary, study leave like LAP, LHAP to grant current. LAP full leave salary denge, right? HRA should be stopped after the 6 months of the study leave. Transport allowance 1 month ke baad stop ho jayega. If he is not rendering full completed calendar month, the employee is not eligible for the transport allowance. So, allowances may have happened. After 6 months of service, study leave, the HRA of the employee should also be stopped. But in case the employee submits that I am still residing in the same residence or same station, or his family is residing in the same residence or same station, then the employee should also be allowed with the HRA on production of certification from the employee stating that he is still residing with the, he has not changed his residence during the study leave also. So, employee ko kya milega? Study leave mein basic pay milega and he is entitled for BA and HRA in case he submits the certification for residing in that same residence. If the employee resigns without serving 3 years or 5 years in case of doctor, then the entire cost of, or he may fail to submit the certificate. May study leave ka naam pe 2 saal visa diya, he enjoyed himself like anything and he failed all the certificates. So he is unable to produce the certificates. In that case also, the employee is liable to refund the entire cost of training. Pura jo paisa wo enjoy kiya hai, that amount should be refunded to the employee. If the VR on medical decategorization death or deputation purely on public interest. अगर कोई deputation relevant में study कर लिया and he is proceeding to the IRGC and somewhere he is proceeding to the other government organization on purely on public interest पे अगर deputation गया तो then the employee is not liable to repay the entire cost of the study unless until if he takes a resignation or BR then the employee is liable to pay the entire cost of the study leave also. Then come to ex-India leave. Ex-India leave is nothing, right? It is not any kind of leave, right? The only thing is employee while proceeding on abroad, before proceeding abroad, he should take the permission of the administration stating that I am going to abroad and the source of income is so. And the very important thing is, right, earlier it was there that the employee who proceeds on ex-India leave should execute a insurance to the medical insurance to the tune of $50,000 for his medical emergencies. But now the rule says if the employee submits a declaration stating that I am aware that I am not entitled for overseas medical reimbursement. अगर कोई किसी को यहाँ से चले गए यूएस में अच्छा ट्रीटमेंट मिल रहा है हार्ट के लिए उनके वहां जाके बाईपास सर्जरी कर लिया एंड ही मे क्लेम दैट ऑन इमरजेंसी आई हैव अंडरवेंट द बाईपास सर्जरी एंड प्लीज रीइंबर्स द कॉस्ट ऑफ द बाईपास सर्जरी. यहाँ से वहां आई थिंक इट इज मोर टाइम्स ये रहता है कॉस्टली रहता है. So he may say that you refund the $50,000. So it is not permissible, right? As per medical manual, it is not permissible. And while proceeding on ex-India leave, the employee should execute a declaration stating that I am aware that I am not eligible for the medical reimbursement, overseas medical reimbursement, and I will pay all the cost of medical expenses while on overseas. अगर वो सर्टिफिकेशन दे दिया तो एम्प्लॉय कैन बी सैंक्शन ऑन हिज खुद का लीव है ओन लीव ओनली लीव ड्यू टू हिम ओनली विल नॉट सैंक्शन एनी एक्स्ट्रा डेबिट और क्रेडिट ऑफ एक्स इंडिया लीव विल नॉट बी ले राइट. वो एलए भी ले सकता है एलएचए भी ले सकता है एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी लीव से ले सकता है एंड ही कैन प्रोसीड ऑन अब्रॉड. ओनली थिंग इज ही हैज टू टेक द परमिशन फ्रॉम द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन दैट इज अबाउट द एक्स इंडिया. Then come to very important child care leave. Child care leave, a female railway servant को भी child care leave eligibility दिया गया है. शायद most of us may not be aware of this. Right? You please refer RBE number 64/2019. RBE number 64/2019 में तीन चार leave kinds of leave का amendment दिया चुका है. Right? So a female railway servant को पहले से ही मिल रहा है. इट इज इफेक्टिव विद इफेक्ट फ्रॉम 1/9/2008 से फीमेल रेलवे सर्वेंट आर एलिजिबल फॉर द सीसीएल. बट नाउ सिंगल मेल रेलवे सर्वेंट फीमेल रेलवे सर्वेंट एज वेल एज ए सिंगल मेल रेलवे सर्वेंट. सिंगल मेल रेलवे सर्वेंट का मतलब क्या है डेफिनेशन क्या है अनमैरिड. आप देखिए कहां तो भी मैरिड बोल के काम भी नहीं बोल रहे हैं. ए सिंगल मेल रेलवे सर्वेंट अनमैरिड or widower or divorcee. Single male railway servant ka definition hai unmarried or widower or divorcee, right? A female railway servant and a single male railway servant having less than is eligible for maximum 730 days of CCL. 30 days of CCL to take care of two eldest surviving children. Yahan bhi aap par please note this. Two eldest surviving children. Surviving is the very very important point here, right? Suppose one of the employees teen bachche hai pura. One of the employees having three children. Two are already attained the age of 18 years. Third bachcha is only 15 years of age. All of a sudden, one of the 18 इयर्स क्रॉस हो चुका, एक 18 इयर्स क्रॉस होने के बाद एक बच्चा गुजर गया। थर्ड बच्चा इज नाउ द टू एल्डेस्ट सर्वाइविंग चिल्ड्रन में एक बच्चा का एज है 15 इयर्स। सो एम्प्लॉय कैन अवेल द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द बैलेंस ऑफ सीसीएल फॉर द थर्ड चाइल्ड आल्सो बिकॉज़ ही इज सैटिस्फाइंग दिस कंडीशन ऑफ टू एल्डेस्ट सर्वाइविंग चिल्ड्रन। एल्डेस्ट सर्वाइविंग चिल्ड्रन का एजुकेशन एंड सिक का पर्पस के लिए द फीमेल रेलवे सर्वेंट एंड अ सिंगल मेल रेलवे सर्वेंट कैन बी सैंक्शन विद अ मैक्सिमम ऑफ 730 डेज ऑफ सीसीएल इन एंटायर सर्विस। अगर चाइल्ड का एज 20 इयर्स होगा कैन वी सैंक्शन? नो। सो द चाइल्ड एज शुड बी बिलो द एज ऑफ 18 इयर्स, बिलो द एज ऑफ 18 इयर्स। इन केस ऑफ अपस्प्रिंग चिल्ड्रन, अपस्प्रिंग का मतलब है स्पेशल डिजेबिलिटी चिल्ड्रन और डिजेबल्ड चिल्ड्रन, पर्सन विद डिजेबिलिटी, पर्सन विद डिजेबिलिटी ऑफ मिनिमम ऑफ 40% डिजेबिलिटी है तो एनी एज ऑफ 40% डिजेबिलिटी पर्सन। इन केस ऑफ नॉर्मल चाइल्ड इट इज 18 इयर्स, अप टू द एज ऑफ चाइल्ड एज ऑफ 18 इयर्स the female railway servant or single male railway servant can be sanctioned with the maximum of 730 days of CCL, right? And it should not be sanctioned more than 3 spells in a calendar year. ये पूरा calendar year का हिसाब से रहता है। It should not be sanctioned with the 3 spells in a calendar year. And in case of single female parent, in case of single female parent, कोई widow है, divorcee है, सिंगल फीमेल पेरेंट है, सो इन दैट केस द सिंगल फीमेल पेरेंट शुड बी सैंक्शन विद द 6 स्पेल्स ऑफ चाइल्ड केयर लीव एंड द मिनिमम टू बी नॉट लेस देन 5 डेज ऑफ चाइल्ड केयर लीव शुड नॉट बी सैंक्शन। इट शुड बी सैंक्शन मिनिमम 5 डेज और मोर ओनली एंड द मैक्सिमम ऑफ सीसीएल कैन बी अवेल्ड एट ए टाइम इज 730 डेज। एंटायर अमाउंट ऑफ सीसीएल कैन बी अवेल्ड एट ए स्ट्रेच ओनली। But if I am saying that not more than 3 spells in a calendar year, if कोई apply को December में भी sanction किया हो CCM, December में sanction किया हो, and the very next immediate year February में CCL खत्म हो रहा है, 90 days sanction किया हो, and it is expiring, leave expire हो रहा है February में, so whether it should be counted in both the years? प्रीवियस सैंक्शन ईयर में काउंट करना एंड सब्सिक्वेंट ईयर में काउंट करना, नहीं तो ओनली प्रीवियस ईयर में काउंट करना है। सो इट शुड बी काउंटेड इन द ईयर ऑफ प्रीवियस ईयर अकाउंट ओनली व्हेन द लीव सैंक्शन लीव इज फॉलिंग इन 2 इयर्स, इन 2 इयर्स देन इट शुड बी काउंटेड इन द सैंक्शन ईयर, लीव सैंक्शन ईयर में काउंट करना है, इट शुड नॉट बी काउंटेड इन द सब्सिक्वेंट ईयर। And this is very, very, very important, right? It is applicable earlier, prior to 14-12-2018, the employee is eligible for the 100% salary. Prior to 14-12-18, employee is eligible for the 100% of salary. Now there is condition is there. If the employee is availing the CCL within the first 360 days of her eligibility or his eligibility, then the employee is eligible for 100% salary. If the employee is sanctioned or availing the CCL beyond the first 365 days of her eligibility, that is, I say 366th day to 730 days, then the employee is eligible for only 80% of her salary. अगर कोई 10,000 का बेसिक पे ड्रा कर रहा है हर महीना एंड शी इज सैंक्शन विद द सीसीएल बियॉन्ड हर फर्स्ट 364 डेज ऑफ एलिजिबिलिटी देन द एम्प्लॉय शुड बी पेड सैलरी ऑन बेसिक पे ऑफ 8,000 ओनली, दैट इज 80% ऑफ हर और हिज बेसिक पे। दिस इज द कंडीशन, न्यू कंडीशन can be combined with any other kind of bill. And the CCL balance sheet should be maintained. CCL balance sheet should be maintained. This is about the child care leave. Whether surrogacy mother is eligible for CCL? No, surrogacy mother is not eligible for the mother. because she don't have, doesn't have any right on the child. Once the child born, she should hand over their natural parents. So surrogacy mothers are not eligible for the child care. Even adoptive mother also eligible for the child care on par with the natural mother. There is no difference between the adoptive mother and the natural mother. So then comes to very important and very basic work related illness and injury. In short form, we are saying it FRIL. This is also amended and promulgated with effect from 14/12/2018. Please refer, once please refer 64/19, RBE number 64/19 8 refer PCA, you will come to know the amendments to the leave rules, amendments to the leave rules, right? Earlier we used to, if any of the employees suffers with any injuries while working on his, while executing his official duties, they are eligible for the hospital leave and disability leave and the special disability leave. This work-related illness and injury leave is subsumed with the special disability leave and hospital leave. So hospital disability, special disability leave and the hospital leave will become history now, redundant now. It is omitted from the leave rules. So, ये work-related illness and injury review क्या है एक बात देखेंगे, right? Railway servant permanent or temporary who suffers illness or injury, अगर कोई workshop में काम कर रहा, he is working with the some dangerous chemicals. Because of working with the chemicals or liquids, if employee gets some rashes on his skin or some allergy on his skin, right? कोई चोट नहीं लगता है यहाँ, कोई वुंड नहीं आ रहा, चोट नहीं लग रहा, बट ही इज गेटिंग सम इलनेस ड्यू टू हिज ड्यूटी, बिकॉज ही इज डीलिंग विद द सम एसिड्स और सम लिक्विड्स और सम सॉल्यूशन, सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट ही इज फॉलन इल इन दैट टाइम आल्सो एम्प्लॉई इज एलिजिबल फॉर द वर्क रिलेटेड इलनेस एंड इंजुरी लीव. ओके, हु सफर्स इलनेस और इंजुरी दैट इज अट्रिब्यूटेबल और aggravated in the performance of her or his official duties or in consequence of her or his official position are eligible for FRIL with full payment for the entire period of hospitalization. Earlier, as per hospital leave should be sanctioned to the employees, non-gazetted employees, who suffers injuries during performance of their official duties. Agar koi ALP is went on duty, agar during the course of his official duty, if he is executing some gaadi mein usko chot lag gaya, right, achanak chot laga hai, he is eligible for hospital leave. Why ALP during the course of his duty, official duty, he went for washroom and he skid ho gaya, fall ho gaya, injuries ho gaya. In case of hospital leave, he is not eligible for any kind of leave from the, he is not eligible for hospital leave because he is not executing his official duties, bona fide duties execute nahi kar raha. So he should not be sanctioned with the hospital. In case of FRIL, work related illness and injury leave, in case of your official duties chot lag gaya to be you are eligible for leave, or in your official position you are traveling from your residence to your office and you met with the accident, earlier you are not eligible for any kind of leave. Because you are proceeding to duty, it's a part and partial of the duty only. Agar aapko duty nahi hai to aap ghar se kaam kyun nikalte ho, ghar mein hi baithte ho. So as you are, it's a part of the duty, part and in consequence of your official duty, you are eligible for the FRIL. Right? Earlier it is not there. And in hospital leave, you are eligible for only 120 days of with full payment. 120 days of hospital leave with full payment and maximum up to 28 months 120 days ke baad you are eligible for the half pay leave only irrespective whether you are in the hospital or you are in sick but as per frill work related illness and injury whatever the days or whatever the period it may be you are entitled for the entire hospitalization it may be months it may be years together you are entitled for the full pay for the entire period of hospitalization entire period of hospitalization hospital se bahar aane ke baad full payment in case of other than rpf and rpsf full payment for 6 months after hospitalization and the 2 months of the pay after 6 months after hospitalization agar koi aaj aaj relieve ho gaya hospital se hospital mein 1 saal guzara hospital mein 1 saal guzarne ke baad full payment mila 1 saal ke liye and he released discharged from hospital today so from today onwards the employee will get the 6 months ke liye usko full payment dena hai after completion of that 6 months period of that 6 months the employee is eligible for the half payment for the period of 12 months right in case of rpf staff rpf staff officers ke liye full payment for 6 months after beyond hospitalization period hospitalization ka period mein all the employees are entitled for full payment beyond hospitalization period full payment for 6 months and after the 24 months because of they use they carry the armored forces and they may get injured jyada injured hone ka serious injuries hone ka chances hai that's why the for rpf rpsf staff officers ke liye 6 months after 6 months 6 plus 24 months full 3 saal ka 3 saal ka 30 months sorry 30 months they will get the full payment full payment in case of non gazetted staff of rpf and rpsf there is no limit for the entire period of hospitalization and the entire period of their sick period will they will get the full payment of leave salary during the frill period and two important things very important things while you are sanctioned or if anybody is sanctioned with the frill you should take care of this if anybody is sanctioned with the compensation under workmen compensation act if anybody is sanctioned with the compensation with workmen compensation act under workmen compensation act the amount of frill the salary amount of frill should be debited अगर किसी को अपन 6 महीने का सैलरी दिया एंड द सैलरी कॉस्ट इज 6 लाख एंड द सेम एम्प्लॉई इज गेटिंग द 10 लाख ऑफ कंपनसेशन अंडर वर्कमैन कंपनसेशन एक्ट देन वी हैव टू डेबिट द 6 लाख ऑफ लीव सैलरी फ्रॉम हिज वर्कमैन कंपनसेशन एक्ट का पैसे में से 6 लाख कट करना है एंड बाकी 4 लाख उसको एम्प्लॉय को अलो करना है एंड अनदर वन इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग during the period of frill the employee should not be given any credit of LAP or LHS ye to apan mind mein rakhi while dealing with the work related illness and injury leave we have to take care of that any compensation is sanctioned so debit that salary amount and the employee should not be extended with the LAP and LHS credit during the period of I think I am exceeding my time limit, so I will close it within 5 to 10 minutes. Then casual leave. So it is very casual, and you all are aware of it. It is casual leave and special casual leave. CL is not a recorded leave. CL is not a recorded leave. All other kinds of leaves are recorded leave. It is not a recorded leave. Can be sanctioned half day also, either afternoon or morning. The closed holidays in between the CLs will be counted as 21. अगर कोई Friday को छुट्टी ले रहा and Monday को भी छुट्टी लिया CL लिया दो दिन CL लिया, so Saturday Sunday will be counted as a duty only and Saturday Friday only. अभी मेरे 5 minutes समाप्त कर दें. experience will be counted as a duty only. Irrespective of joining time, अगर कोई दिसंबर में जॉइन हो रहा, अगर कोई जुलाई में जॉइन हो रहा, अगर कोई जनवरी फर्स्ट में जॉइन हो रहा, सो ऑल द एम्प्लॉइज आर एंटाइटल्ड फॉर द फुल अमाउंट ऑफ सीएल. ऑफिस स्टाफ के लिए 8+2 days ऑफ आरएच, 8+2 days ऑफ आरएच रहेगा, 8 days का सीएल होगा. आरएच का मतलब है रिस्ट्रिक्टेड हॉलिडे. आज सिकंदराबाद बोनाल हो रहा, सो टुडे इज ए आरएच. Those who are willing, they can take the RH. So total 10 days of CL or RH आएगा. Open line staff को 10 दिन होगा. Open line staff and workshop staff will are eligible for the 10 days of CL in calendar year. In a calendar year. RPF staff are 15 days. In case of a disabled person, this is very important. If anyone is a disabled person, please note. They are entitled for, in addition to these CLs, they are entitled for another 4 days of CLs. Another 4 days of for CLs to attend the medical things for the regular checkups or anything. Disabled persons are eligible for 4 days addition, in addition to per calendar year, in addition they are eligible for the CL. In case of North East Frontier Railway, they are entitled for another 5 days of additional 5 days of CLs. So cannot be combined with LAP vacation or joining time. CL cannot be combined with LAP vacation or joining time, and cannot be accumulated also. Right? You have been credited with the 10 days of LAP CL. You have availed only 5 days of CL during the entire year, so that 5 days will be lapsed. It cannot be accumulated further. After CL, for debit for 3 late attendance or early leaving the office without permission. If any employee remains, attends office for 3 days, 3 days of absent in a calendar month, or he leaves the office early, that is only up to 1 hour only. You cannot say that last half an hour you came to office and I said today I got late, but you take half day, debit half day CL. So that is not right. So one hour of the late attendance or early leaving office for three occasions in a calendar month is liable to be half day of CL should be debited. And the special CLs, you all are aware that special CL will be sanctioned on sports account, scouts account, scouts and guides account. Those who are donated blood, they are eligible for 1 day of special CL. And for participating in PNM or society meetings, credit society meetings, cultural events, parades, the people day parades or independence day parades, or civil disturbances like COVID, or any floods or anything, civil disturbances. So during the COVID period, we have sanctioned special CLs also, right? And to encourage the small family also. So in case of male railway servant, if he is undergoing vasectomy sterilization, he is eligible for 6 days of special CL. 6 days of a special CL. CL and a special CL, please always note that it is excluding closed holidays and public holidays, Saturday, Sundays, right? So 6 days of special CL, a male driver servant underwent, if he is going vasectomy, then he is eligible for 6 days special CL. And in case if his wife is undergoing tubectomy operation, then the employee is eligible for 3 days of special CL. Some people say so that my wife has underwent 6 months back tubectomy. Can I avail the special CL now? It is not permissible. At the time of tubectomy only. To take care of his children. Because his wife is undergoing the tubectomy operation. She cannot take care of his children. So he has to remain at home and he has to take care of his children and wife. That's why he will be sanctioned with the 3 days of special CL, right? In case of if wife, husband is undergoing a vasectomy operation, then female railway servant husband is undergoing a vasectomy operation, then the female railway servant can be sanctioned with the 1 day of special CR. In case of female railway servant herself is undergoing the tubectomy sterilization. Earlier it was 10 days, now it is made 14 days, now it is revised to 10 days. So female railway servant undergoing tubectomy sterilization operation, they are eligible for 10 days of special CR. Then joining time, whenever employee transfers on administration grounds, employee is eligible for the joining time within the same municipality limits, right? If some of the employees are transferred from Secunderabad to Hyderabad and there is no chance of shifting his residence also, he cannot shift his residence within the same limit of municipality or corporation, the joining time is 1 day only. He can join the same time. And less than 1000 kilometers, if the newly transferred headquarters is far from his old headquarters station or headquarters, if it is less than 20 kilometers, then the employee should be sanctioned with the 10 days of joining time. If it is more than 1000, then he should be sanctioned with the 12 days. And if it is more than 2000 kilometers, then he should be sanctioned with the 15 days of joining time to shift his residence and to settle his family at the new residence. In case of air travel, more than 2000 kilometers, and in case of air travel, it should be restricted to the 12 days. More than 12 days should not be granted in case of air travel. If not availed, koi yahan se Kalipeta transfer hua. Employee is transferred from Secunderabad to Kalipeta. And he settled his family, he shifted his residence, duly availing 5 days of joining time. Duly availing 5 days of joining time. And after availing 5 days of joining time, he resumed the duty. He effected his transfer and he duty karna lagaya. So, baki 5 din ka, as the Kalipeta to Secunderabad distance is 150 kilometers, it's about 150 kilometers, he is entitled for 10 days of joining time. But he avoided only 5 days of joining time. So, remaining part of the joining time should be credited to his eligibility balance. If not available, the remaining portion will be credited to eligibility. Right? If anybody doesn't avoid even 1 day of joining time, and the joint resumed the duty, affected the transfer, then the entire period of the joining time, entitled joining period should be credited to his LAP account. Should be credited to his LAP account. But so many people are rising, so many employees are, some departments are rising the question mark that once the employee is joined, affected his duty, and after rendering 2 to 3 days of his duty, now he wishes to avail the joining time. So it cannot be permitted. Once the employee is joined the duty or affected the transfer orders or promotion orders, the question of joining time does not arise. Joining time is entitled only before, prior to joining the or affecting the transfer order. Once joined, that amount of entitlement, eligible amount of joining time will be credited to the LAP account, and the employee can avail the LAP or LHAP or CP. Right? Next, encashment of leave salary. You all are aware that you may be enjoying the leave salary during service also. So, 6 times in entire service, 6 times in entire service in blocks. In 2 years block is there. Each block starts on 1st September of 2008 and ended on every 2 years block is there, and each block we can avail along with the pass or PT. And the maximum amount of leave salary can be encashed is 10 days for each occasion in 6 times during entire service of the employee. And at the time of cessation of service, रिटायरमेंट, कंपल्सरी रिटायरमेंट और वॉलंटरी रेजिग्नेशन, वॉलंटरी रेजिग्नेशन एट द टाइम द एम्प्लॉय कैन एनकैश द मैक्सिमम ऑफ 300 डेज ऑफ एलएपी, 300 डेज ऑफ एलएपी कैन बी एनकैश इफ एलएपी बैलेंस सफिशिएंट बैलेंस इज नॉट देयर, 300 एलएपी बैलेंस इज नॉट देयर. To make good that 300, we have to take the remaining balance from the LHAP amount. Suppose one employee is having 200 days of LAP at his credit and 300 days of LHAP at his credit. To make good that 300 days, we have to take the 100 balance of 100 days LHAP balance. LHAP should be paid on half pay only, 200 days on full payment, and remaining 100 days, whatever the amount of LHAP balance we have taken for to make good out of the 300, that 100 days LHAP should be paid with the half salary only. Thank you very much. Just I will go the chart box.
Good afternoon, sir. I have few doubts. Can I ask the question now?
Chalo, some people are requested for part in Hindi, but I am not familiar with the Hindi. From next session onwards, I will try to I will improve in Hindi. Right. Thank you. If employee is already hospitalized, union cell, if employee is already hospitalized and not able to speak or write anything, who will send application to office for leave? If LHAP is not available in his account. So any of the family members with the support of the medical certificate can request for the any kind of leave, right? As the employee is not having sufficient balance of LHAP or LAP, he can request for the EOL, extraordinary. Sir, if one has two children and in past she has availed 180 days, can avail again ML for third baby. Only thing is the condition is if any employee is having less than two surviving children, if she already have two surviving children, I have given one example also, one lady, one female railway servant is blessed with the twins in first instance and she is going for the third issue, second issue but the third baby, as she is not satisfying that less than two surviving children condition, she is not eligible for the third baby. For third baby she is not eligible for the ML. Stepchild, please repeat the stepchild in ML. If anyone have stepchildren of their earlier spouse, with their earlier spouse. So if employee goes on his own going for the first instance, then employee is eligible for the maternity leave or paternity leave. What if the first child is adopted? She can get the ML for second adoption. Definitely she will get for the second adoption as she or he is satisfying the less than two surviving children at the second condition at the time of second adoption. PPT already I have posted in this thing, chart box, you may download. Mr. Ranpal Singh, you may download. Then whether injured on duty is the same as the prill. Yes, it is in the course of while performing official duty or in the course of in your official capacity. See, now I came to Sitara on duty and while going back, if I got any injury, so I am rightly eligible for the even though I am not performing my official duty at the time of my injury, I am as it is in the course of my duty only, I am rightly eligible for the drill. an employee who don't have any leaves in his ESTC GVR, leaves in his kind of, what kind of leave can he apply for? If the employee is undergoing for any medical treatment, if the employee is undergoing for any medical treatment, with the support of medical certificate, the employee can be sanctioned with the leave not due of maximum 360 days, or the employee can avail for the extraordinary leave without pay, extraordinary leave without any leave pay. An employee who is shifted to another station on redeployment, is the employee yes definitely eligible? The employee who is redeployed or medically decategorized and posted to another station or administration ground, if the medical decategorized employee or surplus employee, if on his own he requested to post for certain specific station, at that time he is not eligible for the joining time. But if he is posted on his own on administrative account, then the employee is rightly eligible for the joining time. Sir, please share detail and other related matter. So somebody is requesting to share the leave related matter on mobile, that I cannot do. Please, if you want to access the PPT which is already posted in chat box, please kindly accept it. What about the 300 of this LAP? The LAP of the maximum after accumulation of 300 days, the 15 days of advance credit should be shown as a separate. And if employee is availed any kind of LAP, that the availed amount of LAP should be first debited from the 15 days, then it should be after 300 days, maximum 315 days of LAP can be accumulated. WhatsApp group that Sitara will take, send PDF that already is LHAP. What is the procedure? Sir, for availing, Janaki is requesting, what is the procedure to be followed to avail LHAP for provider? As usual, you just give a LAP application, you just mention kind of leave as LHAP for provider files, or provider files for any reason, domestic reason, and you can avail the LHAP only begins that you will get the half of your salary for the computing that period. Bona fide duties means, suppose bona fide duties means if ALPA is bona fide duties, he should run the file. Bona fide duty means why? Right? After completion of his duty, he is proceeding to his residence. So that will not be called as a bona fide duty. That is, in the course of duty, he is proceeding on going to his residence. It is part and parcel of the duty. But bona fide duty means, jo abhi kaam main kar raha hu na, bona fide duty. It is my duty to take class. And now I will proceed to my office. That is not a bona fide duty. That is in my official capacity. I am traveling from Sitara to my office. Adding or not. 300 plus add karna hai. 300 plus 15 dikhana hai. Is not available in chat box or something. Training institutes. What are the new rules for training institutes like? Same rules. Training institute ko bhi same rules hai. There is no extra kuch bhi nahi. Because they want like school staff ko dusra rules hai. Our training institutes, they want to enjoy any vacations, right? Summer vacation, even in summer also, even winter also, we conduct the training institutes conduct the seminars or classes. That's why they are not, there is no specific rules for the training institutes. Yes, definitely they are eligible if they satisfy the conditions mentioned in the real condition mein jo mention kiya wo hai. Thanks for the redeployment options. Yes. If the employee is requested from particular station during the redeployment or medical decategorization, then they are not eligible. Right? Option D for station, they are not eligible. Sahadev is 135 and quitting now. Thank you. Thank you very much.